Hi everyone, welcome to our demo on sending WhatsApp flows with Infobip solutions. I'm Tracy, and in this video, we will show you two ways to send WhatsApp flows. First, with Infobip Broadcast and Infobip Answers. With the help of our AI assistant, Nova, we will guide you through the process of sending automated, personalized WhatsApp flows to the end users. If you like to skip to specific sections, feel free to use the chapters to find the parts that you are most interested in. Let's get started.
Let's begin by sending the WhatsApp flow via Infobip Broadcast. Step 1. Create a WhatsApp template for the welcome message. The first step is to create a WhatsApp template. This template will be the welcome message that end users see when they enter the WhatsApp flow. Start by navigating to the Infobip web interface. Go to Channels and Numbers, Channels, select WhatsApp, choose Sender, and click on Register Template for the sender you want to use to send the WhatsApp flow. Since we're sending a lead generation WhatsApp flow, select Marketing Template, and then choose Flow Template. For a more detailed introduction to WhatsApp templates, refer to the Infobip WhatsApp course. Name the template, select the language, and start crafting the content, including the button text. You can find your flow ID on WhatsApp Business Account, also known as WABA, or via APIs. Paste the flow ID here and select Navigate for static WhatsApp flows. If you are creating a dynamic WhatsApp flow, you'll need to select Data Exchange. You can also find the screen ID in both WhatsApp Business Account or via APIs. Customize the header and footer as needed. Step 2. Register the template. Once you've finished designing, click Register Template to complete the creation of the welcome message for the WhatsApp flow. This template will now serve as the first point of contact for end users entering the WhatsApp flow. Step 3. Sending via Infobip Broadcast. Now that the WhatsApp flow template is registered, let's move to Broadcast to send the message we just created. Enter your recipients and select the sender. Double-check to ensure everything looks good. If everything is in order, click on Continue to Preview to review the message before sending it. When you're ready, click Launch to send the welcome message to the end users and initiate the WhatsApp flow, starting their journey with the business. Now, let's move on to how to send WhatsApp flow via Infobip Answers. Step 1. Create a chatbot and select the WhatsApp flow element. Go to Infobip Answers. Start by creating a new chatbot. Choose the WhatsApp flows element under the build section. This is where you'll set up the initial interaction when an end user enters the WhatsApp flow. You can design a welcome message to greet them, and a button text to encourage them to start interacting with the flow. Step 2. flow information setup. Next, head to the flow information section. Here, you'll enter the flow ID, which you can find in WhatsApp business account. You'll also need to choose the flow status and enter the flow token, which serves as an identifier for the flow. Since we're creating a static flow that follows a predefined sequence, we'll select Navigate under Flow Action. Enter the ID of the first screen, which will be the entry screen name you've defined in WhatsApp business account. Step 3, save user responses. In this lead generation flow, we want to collect user data, such as their names, email addresses, and which product type they've chosen. To save this information, go to Save Response to Attribute. You can find the correct path in the JSON coding under Payload, and input it into the corresponding fields here. You can also set up a repeat message that will trigger if the user input is unrecognized, as well as a fallback action to ensure smooth user interaction if something goes wrong. Step 4, add the people profile element. Now let's add the people profile element. Since we're building a lead generation flow, we need to collect all the user inputs into Infobip People CDP. In this step, choose Create or Update Person Profile as the action. For the contact information attribute, map the user's information, like name, email, and product type choice, to the corresponding fields in Infobip People CDP. This will ensure that you have all the important details captured and organized in the system. Because product type is not in the predefined attribute list, we need to create a custom attribute in People CDP to capture the product type choice. To do this, go to People Configuration Person Custom Attributes. Click on Create Custom Attribute, give it a name, select the appropriate data type, and then click Save. This custom attribute will allow you to store specific user data, like the product type they've chosen, and keep it organized in the People CDP. Step 5, activate answers to launch the WhatsApp flow. Now that we've created the custom attribute to record the product type the end users have chosen, let's go back to answers and map it out. Once everything is ready, click Activate to launch the WhatsApp flow.
If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, or drop a comment to share your thoughts with us. We've got more demos and updates coming, so stick around and join us on this learning journey. See you next time!